Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Terry Pullen, who is the CEO of GreenBank Capital, and we've got Vili, who's the chairman and CEO of Ubique Minerals. And the reason we have both of these gentlemen on the line is that yesterday, Terry, you and I were talking about your recent private placing, in which people will be given the opportunity to get an option on Ubique Minerals. And so we're going to find out a little bit more about Ubique Minerals straight from the horse's mouth. So Vili, start us off by telling us a bit about it.
Yeah, thank you very much, Thomas. Nice to be with you. So Ubique Minerals is now in the middle of or coming to the end of closing a transaction in Namibia. It involves buying a previously operated mine that was operating until May 2020. The mine is a lead, zinc and silver mine. It was an operational mine for a couple of years, but was forced to shut down because of COVID. We've been over the past, almost 12 months acquiring it, getting all the necessary approvals. And we're now in the final mist of closing the transaction and its final funding stages. And we've got GreenBank willing to take part in that placement for Ubique. GreenBank, of course, being Ubique's cornerstone investor with about 20% stake, and they've supported us through the whole process. So it's a real pleasure to feel that that's an ongoing support.
Understood. So is it really just that outstanding bit of money that's holding you back?
Yes. So it's just this final payment that we're now going through, and we expect the transaction to close very shortly. Post-closing, what we'll do is we'll go immediately into what we call the restructuring phase of the current state of the mine. And we expect to, if everything goes well, to be in production before the end of the year.
Fantastic. So perhaps you could just summarize what it is that you think investors should find attractive about the project.
Well, the core component of it is, of course, how short we can be into production. So the mine is a proven case. It was operating successfully when it was closed because of the pandemic. And therefore, it's technically sound, it's geologically sound, and we've got a very clear vision of where we're going to take it, how we're going to reopen it, and how we're going to make it cash flow positive. We've got a very, that we feel is a very fair and good agreement with the vendors of the property, the former owners. And so we are quite upbeat with the basic, it's a basic project. It's not complicated. We're not trying to explore. We're not trying to invent anything. It's plain vanilla, getting out there, get it done, get the cash in house.
Understood, Vili. Thank you very much indeed. Now I'm going to turn back to you, Terry. We were chatting about one of the other elements of this placing yesterday, and that is Kiind, which is, I believe, a charity platform. If you can tell us more about it.
Certainly, yeah. Thank you, Thomas, and thank you, Vili. We're very happy to support Vili and through GreenBank. You know, Vili's got incredible background experience. So this is not a speculative approach from people who don't know what they're doing. You know, Vili is expert in the mining world with lots of previous success. So we're very excited about the strategy that Ubique have to fit with the GreenBank strategy of investing in businesses that are close to income or taking income. So, yeah, very, very keen to support Vili. Thomas, we mentioned yesterday about Kiind, which essentially is a matchmaking platform between charities and businesses. People don't truly appreciate the gap that is between charities and businesses in a technological sense. What we've actually come up with is a solution that's being provided by a tried and proven software producer that's produced matchmaking platforms around the world. So we've got the tech. We got the tech back up. We've got a minimum viable product available to us in 6 weeks. Again, with a launch date the Q4 this year. So we believe we've come up with a solution. We've come up with the tech, part of the placing money will be towards that next stage.
So Terry, how is that work currently being undertaken then, without the use of products like yours?
It actually isn't. The interesting thing, Thomas, is that what's happened in that world has been a lack of change, a lack of disruption, a lack of tech implementation, and you know, many many people walk from a station, and you know, and they have, you know, young people that will stop them in the street and ask for the ability to, you know, to make monthly payments into, you know, good causes. Of course, those types of approach cost money. What we're suggesting is that the right money goes to the right people at the right time, and 100% of the money is delivered. That's obviously a great asset to charities who require a more direct digital a platform to be able to show what their needs are and how monies can be given from business to those good needs. Businesses, on the other hand, clearly have a responsibility in a corporate sense and corporate social responsibility sense. And they find it actually very difficult to know when they give money in a sort of charitable way, where it goes, what it does, how it gets there, and what the actual outcome is, what that tangible outcome is. So whilst they, you know, they many businesses are aware that they need to have a CSR program, they don't actually have a digital platform to connect to the charities that may wish to support. And once again, all we're doing is bridging that gap in a simple digital way.
And so, Terry, where do the revenues come from for the product?
We to ensure that we are ourselves, you know, we're following our own methodology of corporate governance and CSR. We've actually come up with a subscription model. And the benefit of that subscription model is there's 100% clarity and 100% transfer of funds from a business to a charity if one was choosing to make a donation towards a tangible project that the charity requires. We will actually not charge charities. That will be subscription fee free if the charity raises less than £25,000 a year. So we actually believe that we're going to be doing a great service to charities that need support and help in finding new ways to raise money. And we're going to provide our tech for free. Over and above that amount of money, then the charities will have a try it, you know, we hope you like it approach. And then they will, if they do like it, they will pay a monthly, you know, minimal subscription fee to post their appropriate requirements online. The businesses on the other side of the equation will also have a subscription fee. So none of the monies donated will come to us. They go direct business to charity. The great outcome for the businesses is that what they actually get is, if they do choose to make donations to specific charities that specifically fit their CSR program, the moment they press the button and they send money to those charities, there's an instant transfer of information straight back to the business's website, straight onto the business's website's social media links, and it immediately connects up in an automated way to give that business a great external view on their vision as a company and how they portray themselves.
So two very different and very interesting projects. Gentlemen, thank you very much for your time this morning.
Thank you, Thomas.
Thank you.